In September 1992, Angola was immersed in a civil conflict that reached its most critical point in the following days after an attempt to achieve peace through democratic and multi-party elections in the country. However, 8 opposition parties, notably UNITA, contested the results, claiming that the elections were flawed, as a result of which riots broke out in Luanda, which quickly spread to other regions of the country in just a few days. Thousands to tens and thousands of UNITA members or supporters were killed by MPLA forces across the country in a tragic event known as the Halloween Massacre. My name is Luis. I was born and raised in Angola, in the capital, Luanda, which was not an easy decision to make. I had to leave my family, my friends, where I grew up, everything. Everything I knew from when I was born, I had to leave it behind. I believe you guys agree with me on that. It's not easy. Have you ever live abroad for a longer period of time? Have you ever become a refugee? Have you ever had to leave because of a war? Leave in the comments below. Hello, it's 5:30 in the morning and I'm going on the hunt for my first boat. So it's been about 4 years that I've been thinking about buying this boat. Yeah, it's actually 5:39 a.m. and I need to drive around 7 hours is to Komro to go have a look at this boat. Yes, guys. Left from Norwich at around 5:29 in the morning, heading to Falmouth is in Conroe. I'm going to check a boat today, and it's an awesome 38 from the pictures or photos. It seems to be really good shape. Now I need to go and check it out, and it's a long drive. It's about 7 hours, so I'm now 3 hours and 52 minutes to go, so 385 kilometers to go basically.
Guess what I just saw.
See how long. See you guys later. Looking for Quay Street in Congo. Right, Mutubana. to find the pontoon. Seems like I just found it over there. How do I get there? Okay, there he is. There is the boat. Just need to find a way. I'm here finally.
Sailing, you learn something more, you know, and I think that's important. Yeah. It's a bit of freedom.
It's like when I went to see the boat for the first time, you could see the excitement in my face.
And you can take it to interesting places. But if you wanted to, Chris, while we still had water, you could have run the engine as well. But
oh yeah,
if you get time.
Yeah, let's do it now.
Yeah, okay. Because totally I think we're just about to.
Okay. Yeah.
We're just about to come on the.
Yeah.
I've got a feeling she's just waddling around the bottom.
Yeah, thanks for reminding me. She done that.
What I'll do is turn the battery on now.
Okay. Thank you for the coffee.
You're welcome. At this point, I hire a surveyor. Which was doing the survey of the boat. He had to check the engine, the moisture level on the hull, the sea cogs, everything that had to be checked because I was about to spend quite a substantial amount. So he had to tell me if the boat is fit or if it's good to buy, if it's a good buy or if I'm not buying a lemon. I highly recommend getting a survey done.
Is dry there, I can see that.
Yeah.
And same up forward.
Yeah.
And nose. So otherwise, a new ball anyway, so that's okay.
Yeah.
Structurally, that's fine. Yeah, she'll be foam cored here.
Yeah.
Hammer tested, moisture tested, that's all. Decks are okay.
Decks are good.
No spongy.
Balsa core in the coach roof.
Yeah.
Which is also fine. I think you were vidding it even. That's all okay. So the bulk of the structure is okay, as I thought it probably would be.
Survey day, guys, and it's raining in Conroe, in Falmouth. Well, Conroe, I believe. There is the surveyor taking some pictures. Having a look, the expert. Sometimes you need to take the expert's opinion.
It's actually quite rare for a Tyler hull to get bad osmosis, so this, I think you're fine, it's going to be all right.
Osmosis is typically a result of moisture being trapped within the fiberglass below the gel coat and or top coatings, causing softening in those areas.
Still blistered.
He's using a hammer to assess the condition of the vessel or the hull.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's,
I will see what the surveyor has to tell me regarding the boat, and I will go from there. And based on the survey, I'll talk to the.